Hey, what's up everyone? This is Owen with Motion Array, and today we're going to go over how to make a flag look like it's waving in After Effects. This technique is quick, but the results are really nice. You can see the flag has some shadows and warping to make it really look like it's waving. Alright, let's get started. I'm going to make a new composition and then bring in my flag image. Now, I need to bring in some footage. I'm going to be using this clip of some flowing cloth from Motion Array. It's important to have high quality footage for this technique, as this is what drives the effect. So with my footage in my composition, I'm going to scale it down to fit my composition size. One way I can do this is to right click on the layer and go to Transform, Fit to Comp. This perfectly scales my layer to the exact dimensions of the composition. Now I'm going to pre-compose the footage. This way, if I ever use multiple instances of the footage, which, spoiler alert, I am, I only need to make edits to the pre-comp rather than all the duplicates. I'm going to select the option Move All Attributes into New Composition and click OK. I'm also going to go ahead and turn the pre-comp off, as I don't need to see it anymore. Now I'm ready to apply some distortion to the flag image. To do this, I'm going to go to Effect, Distort, Displacement Map. The default settings aren't what I'm looking for, so I need to make some changes. The first thing I'm going to do is change the displacement map layer to my footage precomp so that it's looking at the footage to drive the displacement. Then I'm going to change the channels the effect is using for horizontal and vertical displacement to luminance. With luminance, After Effects is looking at the brightness of the layer. Where the layer's dark, there won't be much distortion, and where it's light, there will be a lot. I'm going to bump my max displacement up to 10 for both horizontal and vertical to help push the effect. One thing I'm noticing is that I'm getting some weird distortions in my flag. That's got something to do with my footage, so I'm going to go into my pre-comp and check it out. In the footage, I can see there are these tiny little blocks that are reflecting light, and that's what's causing the weird distortions. To fix that, I'm going to add a blur to smooth things out. I'll go to Effects, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Now I'll just crank up the blurriness until things smooth out. I'm also going to check Repeat Edge Pixels to get rid of the dark fade at the edges. While I'm in here, I'm going to make a few more edits to the footage to help out my effect. First, I'm going to crush the levels and add contrast, which will in turn make my displacement more pronounced. I'll do this with Effects, Color Correction, Levels. Then I'll just bring in my black and white values. I'm also going to speed up my footage since the wave is pretty slow right now. By toggling the brackets at the bottom left of my timeline, I expand out some options for in, out, duration, and stretch. I'm going to take my stretch percentage and drop it to 50%. That will make my footage twice as fast. I'm going to call that good and go back out to my main comp. I think the flag's almost there, but what's missing are some shadows on the flag to really sell that waving effect. To add those in, I'm going to duplicate the pre-comp, then I'm going to drag it above my flag layer, set it to multiply, and then turn its visibility on. The shadows are too dark for me, so I'll drop my opacity to 50%. Now I just need to map the shadows to the flag. So I'll duplicate my flag and drag it above the shadow layer. Then I'll change the shadows track mat to alpha mat, so the shadows only appear where the flag is. And there you have it, a waving flag. Well, that concludes this tutorial. I hope you guys found it helpful. If you did, there's plenty more tutorials over at motionarray.com. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.